Jonathan Holt. Hi, Dr. B. Are you familiar with the science on the relationship between insulin resistance and dementia? What's your opinion? Oh, I'm so glad you asked that question. Yes, I am. Again, I'll go down another bunny hole, and I think this bunny hole is very worthwhile. I took the two-day training with Dale Bredesen. You know, Dale wrote the book, The End of Alzheimer's. And, you know, that sounds very aggressive. I would just let you know that if you go to the Alzheimer's Foundation, that's their major ad campaign right now, too. The first Alzheimer's survivor is out there. And so Dale's book publisher was the one that pushed on that title. I think it's a great title. I think it's a great ad campaign for the Alzheimer's Foundation to have out there. There are significant reversal components of cognitive decline. I've seen reversal of cognitive decline in patients that we've dealt with. Now, how did I get interested in cognitive decline? Again, a friend and patient of mine read the book. There was so much interaction and so much overlap between insulin resistance and risk factors for cognitive decline, Alzheimer's, that he said, Ford, you got to do this. And in fact, for a couple of years, I was one of the providers for cognitive decline in Dale's group. We withdrew the focus totally on cardiovascular work. We've thought many times about going back and doing the insulin resistance component of the 39 holes in the roof. That's the Dale Bredesen work. So let me just add one other quick snippet. At the end of that two-day story, Dr. Bredesen walked up and said, well, Ford, what'd you think in terms of the course? I sort of hesitated for it because I didn't know exactly how to say this. It was sort of a critical comment. I said, it was great work. It was a great 2 days. I learned a lot. And he looked at me and he said, but what? And I said, well, here's the concern. I said, you know, I don't know. What do you think? You clearly know that insulin resistance, prediabetes is a big thing. And I would think that it causes at least half of Alzheimer's. And he looked at me funny and I said, what? And he said, no, I would think it causes all of it. Insulin resistance causes all Alzheimer's. And I said, really? I tend to think that too, but I didn't think you did. He said, oh yeah. He said, if you look at the brain, insulin is very much involved. We knew this. Insulin is very much involved in actually creating the biochemical process of creating memory. Because of that discovery, there was a lot of work in actually having people inhale insulin, snorting insulin. That research didn't work, but it still doesn't have anything to do with the fact that insulin is involved with making memories. So anyhow, Dr. Bredesen's point was, so even if you can't measure insulin resistance in the body, we think it's going on and is a major causative component of memory loss in the brain. Now, what he didn't know, and I didn't go into it, I mentioned it, but we didn't go into it. It's the vast majority of insulin resistance in the body is missed. The vast majority of it. Over 90% of people that have insulin resistance don't know it. We're worried about a coronavirus pandemic. We've had a major cardiovascular pandemic, mostly driven by unrecognized, undiagnosed prediabetes. It's not just the major cause of death with heart attack. It's not just the major cause of disability with stroke. It's also the major cause of dementia. It is a much bigger deal than COVID-19. And pardon me for even mentioning COVID-19. It's such a political issue. So I'd like to talk with you a minute about the webinar. People don't understand what the webinar is. It's actually a great way to get some access to healthcare that you're just not going to get any other way. You actually get the lab tests yourself at a local lab, a Quest lab near you, for the inflammation panel and the OGTT and the insulin survey. These are things, inflammation and prediabetes, that your doctor just does not know about. And here's the thing. Harvard Health and many others have said, look, sudden death is not always so sudden. The Hollywood picture that it's a bolt out of the blue is not realistic. It's more like real lightning preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Stop that metabolic storm before the lightning strikes. And here's where that metabolic storm comes from. It's inflammation, and it has to do usually with prediabetes. So again, we actually get labs, we go over them in the webinar, and then you can start finding out how you can prevent that heart attack others said that you couldn't even predict. We can show you how. Thanks.